What are the symptoms of high eye pressure, and how can you differentiate a patient coming in with an eye problem due to elevated eye pressures versus another eye diagnosis? I'm Dr. Jasper Trotter, board-certified ophthalmologist. The normal range of intraocular pressure, or IOP, is generally 10 to 21, and the relationship between the eye pressure and symptoms can vary based on the rate at which the IOP increased, so whether it was a rapid increase or maybe it was slow over time. The cause of the increased IOP, as well as the patient's ocular history, like do they have a personal or family history of glaucoma, do they already have optic nerve damage, etc. But there are some common generalities that can help when you're working up an eye patient. Common symptoms of an elevated eye pressure include a red eye, eye pain. I've had some patients describe it as a headache in the eye, brow pain or ache, tenderness around the eye, blurry vision, halos around lights, light sensitivity, headache, nausea, vomiting, as well as clear drainage or tearing. If a patient's baseline eye pressures are in the mid-teens, but then it rapidly increases to the 30s and especially the 40s, 50s, or even higher, that can lead to some pretty intense symptoms, and these patients can be miserable. The list of symptoms that we just went through, a lot of them can occur in other ophthalmology diagnoses, but there are some clues that I want to highlight that can help clue in whether or not what you're seeing is due to elevated eye pressure. Brow pain or brow ache. An example, an irritated red eye with a brow ache in a patient where the brow clinically looks unremarkable. So there's no vesicular rash to suggest or be zoster, no infection or trauma. And maybe this patient never had a brow ache like this before. A headache, especially in someone who usually doesn't get headaches or migraines. So an example, an acute red eye, blurry vision, dull headache in a glaucoma patient who ran out of their glaucoma drops 3 weeks ago. Nausea and vomiting. This is more commonly seen when the pressure acutely increases, like an acute angle closure glaucoma, where the pressure can get pretty high. A rule of thumb to keep in mind, a patient with any eye problem who also has nausea or vomiting, rule out elevated intraocular pressure. I remember in residency seeing a patient, of course it was in the middle of the night, who had acutely elevated eye pressure. And before even measuring the pressure, we did the treatment. I knew the pressure was coming down because their whole mood changed. And it was like the first time I saw a smile, they felt so much better. And it showed me how intense these symptoms can get due to elevated eye pressure. And now looking back, you know, we had some vomit bags in our ophthalmology call room. Makes sense. So eye problem, nausea, vomiting, check the eye pressure. But an elevated eye pressure may not cause symptoms. I've been in clinic where I'm seeing a patient for something completely different that have no symptoms, talking about the weather, and it turns out the pressure is 27, and they had no idea. This may occur if the pressure is mildly elevated, like in the low to mid 20s. Also, if the eye pressure gradually increased over time, like in chronic glaucoma. So just little by little over time, the pressure is slowly increasing. That may not cause problems until it gets to a really high eye pressure. Comparing that to an acute pupillary block glaucoma where the pressure increases and it's like a pressure spike. Those patients are miserable, like we've talked about. And a patient with a high eye pressure may not have symptoms because the pressure, maybe it's falsely elevated. For example, if a patient is tense, holding the breath, or squeezing their eyes, that could falsely elevate the eye pressure. Also, a thicker central corneal thickness may falsely elevate an eye pressure. So as part of the glaucoma workup, a central corneal thickness measurement of each eye is commonly obtained, as well as other glaucoma tests, to help determine whether the eye pressure is truly elevated and to determine whether or not a patient has glaucoma. Ultimately, what's going to give you the answer is doing the eye pressure check. If the first pressure reading is elevated and it's greater than 21, I'll remind the patient to just relax, take a deep breath. Sometimes I'll take a deep breath with them because life is crazy. And just relax, not tense. Remind the patient, don't squeeze the eye, and then recheck the pressure. I'll often recheck the pressure in a series of three so I can get an average and confirm whether or not the pressure is elevated. It's not uncommon at the first reading could be elevated, and then I check two more times and it's within normal. And there's also some variability in the pressure readings that you get, especially depending on how you're checking the eye pressure, whether it's with a tonopen, eye care, or Goldman applanation tonometry. So the eye pressure, but it varies throughout the day. but it's very common that when you check the pressure once, you get one reading, let's say 18. You check again, and then it's 20. You check again, and then it's 17. So that's why I like to do a series of three to get an overall average and to prove to myself that it is within normal or it's elevated. Checking the pressure once and it's 44, gotta check it again. There's just too many things that can falsely elevate the eye pressure. By the way, if you've used a tonopen before, what I'm curious on, what would be your title for a YouTube video based on your experience of a tonopen? Put in the comment section. In summary, an elevated intraocular pressure can lead to many symptoms, especially if it's an acute rapid rise in pressure. Some symptom clues include brow ache or pain, headache, nausea, or vomiting. What will give you the answer is measuring the eye pressure, which is often done with a tonopen, eye care, or Goldmann applanation tonometry. In some patients, an elevated eye pressure may not cause symptoms, like if the pressure increase has been a chronic process or the pressures are mildly elevated. The relationship between eye pressure and symptoms can vary. A pressure of 27 may be asymptomatic in patient A, but causes mild blurry vision and an eye ache in patient B. An elevated eye pressure can be vision threatening, and the higher the pressure, the higher the risk of optic neuropathy and ultimately vision loss. So consult an ophthalmologist when needed. So I hope the video was helpful. If you have certain eye topics or questions that you'd like to learn more about, leave it down below in the comment section. And as you're heading down there, don't bypass the subscribe button. Go ahead and click it. It's a little love tap. Let's make today a good day or night if it's still late hours. And I'll see you in the next video.